Do you need a quick Zodo app walkthrough on an Android tablet? Then this video is for you. Hi there, this is Taz from Freshplan. Today we are going to work with Zodo, which is a great free app. And I believe it is the most popular app for Android users. So I'm going to demonstrate these tutorials on this old Android tablet. So just bear in mind that my interface might be a bit different than one you are used to. What is great about Zodo as a PDF viewer and annotator is that it's a cross-platform app, so you can use it in all kinds of phones and tablets. And with the web application, you can also share, sync, and manage all of your files from the laptop or your desktop. So this app is great for anyone who has different devices and work with different operational systems but need to access your PDFs from everywhere. So let's get started with Zodo interface. When you start Zodo, you see that the interface is quite simple and intuitive. It will show all the documents on your library, and in my case it is sorted by the most recent ones. If you click on the tab on the top left corner of the page, you get access to all of your folders, and here is where you can import items. You can also import files from the cloud. If you want to log in to be able to access your documents from other devices, you can do here in this window too. From the library, you have this little shortcut that's this plus sign where you can add blank templates to start new documents and also PDFs from images, documents, or web pages. And on the top here, you have a couple of displaying options. So now let's open up a document to see the tools that we can use to edit PDFs. This is my gold digital planner with hyperlinked tabs available in my shop. Inside the document, you can tap on your screen to show the toolbar and then tap again to make it go away. Sometimes you want to flip through your pages, and that is easier when the toolbar is not around. But let's bring the toolbar back in and check out some of these icons. At first, you have the simplified toolbar with only a few tools. From here, you are able to search through your document or share this document. You also have some settings options, and then you get to the annotation tools. These are the tools we'll be using most for note-taking and digital planning. If you select a tool and then click again on it, you have extra options for that tool. So the first tool available here are the comment notes. These sticky notes are great to add extra info about something on the page. The next four icons are for text markup tools. So you have the highlight tool, the strikeout tool, the underline tool, and the squiggly tool. All of them offer extra options if you click on them twice. Next, we have the image tool, the signature tool, and the stamp tool in the same place. In my interface, I have to toggle between them by clicking on the item twice, but your interface might be a little bit different. This stamp tool gives you some little digital stickers that you can use to drop in your document. And the signature tool is more for PDF documents that you have to sign online. And the image tool, of course, is to add images to your document. Then next, we have the handwriting tool. This is my favorite tool, of course, for digital note-taking and digital planning. You can use a touch pen like I'm doing here in this example, or a Bluetooth pen, but it also works with your finger. Then next you have the eraser and the highlighter tool that you can use to highlight handwriting text, but also text on your PDF. Text that otherwise you wouldn't be able to edit it because it's part of the page, but you can still highlight it. Further, we have the line tool and the shape tool that you can use to create different sorts of shapes with a variety of options here. And last, we have the selection tool that we can use to select the different items inside the page, and the hand tool to display other areas of the document. And on the X, you exit the annotation tools. Since the digital planner already comes with all the hyperlink tabs that you need, it's super easy to navigate your document and add your remarks or notes in several different pages of your planner. Click on the video on your screen to learn more about how you too can start digital planning using your Android tablet.